Hi, I'm Ben Marriott. Today I'm going to show you how to make animated gradient effects like this in Adobe After Effects. Let's begin. This is the After Effects project we're working on. All the elements are already set up here, so we can concentrate fully on our gradient bubble. There's a bunch of layers shied here, like the face and some of the other extra stuff that you don't need to worry about. So we can hide them and ignore them. One neat thing that I did want to point out is that this distortion happening here is done by using the bulge effect on our egg layer, and I've parented the bulge center to this null over here, and I've also parented that sperm to that null. So whenever I move that null, the sperm follows and distorts our little egg. And you know, I thought that was neat. We're going to start out drawing our gradient egg here in Illustrator. I've just got a black background layer here and the colors already selected out in the swatches over here. So let's start by drawing our egg, and let's make this 665 pixels. Now let's select the gradient mesh tool and make some magic. I'm going to place 2 points around here and here in the circle. And what these do is they split up the shape into different segments, and each one of these segments and points you can attach a color to, and it will smoothly blend with the colors of the adjacent points and segments. Now let's select a direct selection tool with A, click on one of the points around the outside of the circle, and just select some colors from over here in the swatch panel. Now it's important the colors don't clash too much. If I was to select red and put a green one next to it, the colors can get real muddy in here. What I call gradient no man's land. Let's undo those. The center will remain black because in After Effects, we're gonna use the screen blending mode and all the black will just turn invisible. Now we're gonna add a second bubble. So let's copy this with Ctrl C and paste in front with Ctrl F. And let's drag that selection up to the top layer up here. We're going to alternate between these two layers to create that shimmery motion, so we need them to be a little bit different. So let's just rotate this top layer. There we go. Let's flip between. They look pretty different. Let's move these anchor points as well a little closer to the center so we get more color. So one of the layers is going to be a little more illuminated. Done. Let's save. Let's import that Illustrator file by placing Ctrl I. Finding that Illustrator file and making sure we import as composition retain layer sizes and click import. Let's drag these over into our assets folder over here. And we're gonna head into this comp and we're just gonna need to copy those two egg layers from here and then go into our egg 01 layer over here and paste them there. And we can get rid of this bottom shape now as well. Let's make this top layer visible, and we're gonna use an alpha mat to control what's visible on that top layer. And we want that alpha mat to be sort of blobby and moving around. To do that, we're going to create a new solid by pressing Ctrl Y, and the setting should be fine. We'll call that blobby matte. We always label our layers, and I'm going to color that purple because I like all my mattes to be purple. From here, we're going to draw a mask on this solid. So we're going to make sure our pen tool is selected. And for the moment, we're just going to draw an odd shape around here that we're going to manipulate a little later. There we go. A bit like Yoldy fidget spinner. Now let's expand this shape so it fills up most of our egg shape and kind of actually spills over in a few of the sections. And we can adjust this later. Now let's make it warp and move by adding a turbulent displace effect. Everyone's favorite effect. The defaults look pretty good here. So to make it animate, we're going to use the evolution property up here. So we're going to add an expression by holding Alt or Option, clicking on this stopwatch, and adding the expression time asterisk 250. And that just gonna means, and what this expression does means that it will continue to animate in this sort of blobby fashion forever, really, or until the end of the comp, whichever is sooner. That looks pretty good. Let's select alpha matte from our egg 2 layer, and now we can see kind of how it's working. We want a smoother gradient on these lines here. So we're gonna go into our matte, press F to bring up the feather property on our mask, and let's slide that by, let's say, 120. There we go. Now, if we play that back, we can see a little bit of shimmering happening here, but we need some more. Let's also take this opportunity to extend these egg layers to the end of the comp. There we go. we want that shimmering to be a little more intense. So I'm going to rotate both of these egg layers in opposite directions. So I'm going to make a rotation keyframe at the beginning. And then at the end, I'm going to have the bottom one rotate 360 degrees and the top one minus 180. Now let's play it back and see how that looks. Okay, that's looking a little more like it. Now I still want the shimmer to be a little more intense. So what I think I can do is go into this blobby matte selection and just change the mask shape a little bit. Now that's looking pretty good to me. So let's pop out to our main comp and see what we're working with. The first thing we're gonna do is select our egg comp and change the blending mode to screen to make that black invisible. And let's play it back here. That is looking pretty good. Now I've got some glow effects with this egg comp as well. So let's turn those on. And I've got a few glow effects because when I work with glows, I think two or three works a little bit better and you can have a little more control over how the glow looks. I think the fall off will look a little more natural. So you should have your first glow fairly tight and fairly intense towards the edge of your glow. And the second one, have the radius a little bigger and maybe a little less intense. And the third one, the radius much, much larger and the intensity really down low. So it's just got a bit more of an organic sort of fall off. This is also looking a little too bright in the center for me. So what we can do is add a curves effect over here. I'm gonna bring that to the top of our stack so it doesn't affect the glows. And I'm just gonna bring the darks down a little in the middle, not too much. There we go. And you can see when the sperm interacts with the egg, you have this cool effect from the glows now as well. Now you want this gradient shimmer to loop as well. So to do that, I'm gonna make a marker on the egg 01 composition using the asterisk way on the other side of your number pad. And just mark that 1 second in. I'm gonna duplicate that, drag this top one right to the end of the comp so the marker hits the end of the comp, and move this bottom one forward so the marker hits the front. Now the end loops with the front. Now we just need to fade between these two comps using our transparency property. Perfect, now we have a loop. To make the inner bubble of our egg, let's duplicate this egg one comp, so it's egg two. Now we don't want the gradients and the colors of this inner bubble to match too much with the outer bubble. So let's change the rotation a little bit by selecting all of our keyframes. And let's just change it by 60 or so, the number doesn't really matter. I'm also going to scale down these comps by pressing S and changing these both to around 83, I think should work. So if we go into our main comp, now we want that inner bubble to have the same effects, the glows and the bulge that we've already got on our first egg composition. So we're going to duplicate both of these egg one comps here. Let's move them up slightly and let's change the color to orange for kicks. So with those selected, we're going to click on our egg two comp over here in the project panel. Hold Alt or Option, and just drag and drop onto either one of those layers. Awesome, let's play that back. Perfect, it's got our glows and our bulge. Now, I do want to make this bulge effect a little subtler. So I'm going to click on this layer, and in the bulge property, change the bulge height to 1.9, a little lower. So it's a bit more subtler. And I'm also going to adjust the curves on this one a little more, just to make it a little more darker in the middle. I think that should do. Now I want to copy that bulge and that curves effect. So I'm going to select them both with Shift, press Ctrl C, and then paste them onto this layer back here. And I'm going to move those up to the effect stack here and replace the existing curves and bulge layers because we don't need those anymore. All right, I think that's looking pretty good to me. Now I should warn you, when you're working with a lot of gradients like this, one thing that you're going to run into is banding. Banding is an artifact in your render for when the computer tries to compress your file and reduces the amount of color in some frames, and it makes your render look a little like this. Now, to reduce that as much as possible, the best thing to do is to increase the color depth of your project by selecting over here where it says 8-bit, change that to 16-bit, maybe 32-bit if you're spicy. I've never had to go that far. And also add a bit of noise to the whole thing. So I've just got the noise effect on this adjustment layer, and that's set to 5%. Now let's look at it all together. Now the project file is available for you to download down in the description box. Please open it up, have a play with this effect. It's really fun and it gets a really cool result. Maybe try and add it to one of your existing animations. please upload whatever you make to Instagram so I can see it and tag me at Ben_married_ so I can share it with my audience in my stories. Thank you so much for watching. Please let me know in the comments what else you'd like to see from this channel. Would you like more tutorials, some process videos, maybe some freelance insights? I'd love to know. And please don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell icon, share, and absolutely demolish that like button. See you next week.